In the previous video, I showed you how to use the new Kubernetes Gateway API instead of Ingress to expose your services from Kubernetes to internet. We also used Cert Manager to obtain a certificate from Let's Encrypt automatically. In this video, we'll use Gateway API for mesh service-to-service communication. Now, to implement the mesh, you may use different solutions, such as Istio. We're not going to use Istio custom resources, such as destination rules and virtual services, to implement the mesh. Instead, we'll use Gateway API CRUDs. First, we'll deploy a service A to Kubernetes, which is a simple HTTP API based on the Golang Fiber framework. We'll also deploy multiple versions for service B, V1 and V2. For the first task, we'll shift the traffic to only version 1 of the service B using Gateway API. For the second task, we'll simulate the Canary deployment and shift only 10% of the traffic to the new version. With this setup, you can allow the two versions of the service to scale up and down independently without affecting the traffic distribution between them. By default, Istio tracks the server workloads migrated to Istio proxies and configures client proxies to send mutual TLS traffic to those workloads automatically and to send plain text traffic to workloads without sidecars. To visualize the traffic, we'll deploy Prometheus and collect Istio metrics. Then Kiali builds the graph based on the Prometheus metrics, where you can see the service topology. In the same dashboard, you can monitor the traffic and request status codes, which can help to identify the problematic service in your microservice architecture quickly. As always, if you want to follow along, you can use my Terraform code to create your own infrastructure. Terraform init and apply. For each new video, I always update all the providers, libraries, and third-party packages everywhere. If you want to get up-to-date code with each video, subscribe to my channel. Here we have the Terraform code to create VPC and EKS cluster with a single managed instance group. We also need a CSI driver to use EBS volumes in the Prometheus. I created a few very simple scripts that you can run to reproduce the setup. First is deploy.sh. We create Prometheus custom resources first, then Istio CRUDs. However, we're not going to use most of them since we'll use Gateway API CRUDs instead. Those are experimental CRUDs that come with Gateway API. If you want to use Gateway API for mesh service-to-service communication, you need to deploy them. Then create Istio and monitoring namespaces. When it's done, apply the Istio.d folder. Istio.d is a new deployment package for Istio that combines all Istio components, such as Pilot, Galley, and Citadel. Finally, apply monitoring folder that contains Prometheus operator itself, Prometheus, Grafana, and Kiali. After provisioning EKS with Terraform, you need to update the local Kubernetes context using this command. Now run the first deploy script. Before continuing, make sure all the pods are up. It may take a minute. The second script is to deploy our applications to Kubernetes. Let's take a look at the app itself. It's a very simple Golang app that uses Fiber as HTTP framework. We have a couple of variables, service and version. The first struct to describe the device, and the second one is to construct the response from service B to service A. Populate service and version from the environment. We have a single API / devices endpoint for both services. If it's a service A, simply forward the request to service B. If it's a service B, send back the devices and the current version. The version can be V1 or V2. Now, to deploy, first we need to create a Kubernetes namespace. On line 7, monitoring equal to Prometheus label, we needed to select pod monitors object in this namespace. The second one is to let Istio automatically inject sidecars to all pods in the namespace. Then we have a deployment. On line 16, for example, Istio equal monitor label is used for the pod monitor object as well. Using environment variable, we set it to pretend to be service A. Then a typical Kubernetes service of type cluster IP. Then two deployments for service B. Each of them gets different versions. For example, this deployment for version V2, regular Kubernetes service. And finally, the Prometheus pod monitor object to monitor our applications. You can use service monitor, but for that, you need to extra create a service for this particular port. But the functionality of the service monitor and pod monitor is identical. Let's go ahead and deploy. If you get pods in the staging namespace, you'll see a single service A pod and two pods for each version of service B. If you list services, you'll find two of them as well. For now, service B will use round robin algorithm to distribute traffic across service B pods V1 and V2. Since we don't use Gateway API in this video as ingress, let's port forward service A to localhost. Now, when you hit API/devices endpoint, sometimes you get version 2 and sometimes V1. If you port forward service B directly to localhost, usually it will bind a specific pod to your localhost. In that way, you always get the same version. That's why we need a proxy as a service A in this video. By now, we haven't used the Istio functionality yet to direct traffic. Now, when using Gateway API to direct traffic to certain pods, we need to create a regular Kubernetes service for each version. For example, for version V1 and for version V2. To actually use Gateway API inside Kubernetes, we need to create HTTP route. Keep it in mind, we use Gateway API custom resource, not Istio custom resource. When you use it as ingress in the parent ref, you will specify the Gateway object. To use it in Kubernetes as a service mesh, you, instead of Gateway, put the regular Kubernetes service. No Istio destination rules or virtual services. There is only one custom resource, this one, which is, in my opinion, simplifies the deployment and reduces the learning curve. Now, under backend ref, you just put another regular Kubernetes service where you want to route traffic. In this case, we want to route traffic to only version V1 of the service B. Even if it's using mostly plain Kubernetes object, you need to have sidecars injected in your pods for this to work. Let's apply additional service BV1, then service for version 2 only, and finally the route itself. If you get services now, you should have 4 of them. As you can see, service B routes traffic to both pods, and service V1 and V2 only to a single pod. Whenever you create HTTP route object, verify that accepted is true and all references are resolved. For example, if you reference non-existing Kubernetes service in the route, you'll get a warning message here. Alright, let's try it again. Use curl to hit API/devices endpoint. Now, for every single request, you'll get a version V1. Let me use load generating tool to simulate some traffic. Here we have a single virtual client that is rate limited to 10 requests per second. When we applied the monitoring folder, it also included Kiali tool to visualize the mesh. Let's port forward and access it using the browser. For this dashboard to work, you must have Prometheus and collect Istio metrics. Kiali uses those metrics to build the graphs. Under the graph, you can see our entry point service A that uses latest Dogger tag. Then service A sends requests using service B Kubernetes service, and we have HTTP route that modifies the service B to route traffic to only version V1 of the service B. You can switch between namespaces and use different graphs. You can also click on the service to get traffic in real time. For example, here our service B V1 receives around 10 requests per second, and all requests return with 200 HTTP status code. This can be very helpful if you have a large number of services and you need to quickly check what service fails for some reason. You can also get the latency and possibly have a link to Grafana with more detailed metrics for debugging. Now, let's simulate the Canary deployment when you expose a new version of your application to a very limited number of clients. If you would do it using regular Kubernetes objects, you would need to scale your pods. For example, here we want to shift 10% of the traffic to the new version and keep 90% using the V1 version. To achieve this with regular deployment, you would scale your version V1, for example, to 10 pods, and version 2 to 1 pod. Now, let's apply it. We don't need to restart anything. This operation will not cause any downtime whatsoever. On the dashboard, you can see two versions of your service B. If you click on V1 version, you'll notice that the traffic was reduced slightly since we sent only 90% to this version, which is around 9 requests per second. If you click on V2, you'll notice that this version just started to get traffic and it gets only around 1 request per second, which is 10% of the traffic. Now, I have to warn you that this feature of Gateway API is still in experimenting phase, so APIs may change in the future. But it's clearly stated in Istio documentation that this is the future for the service mesh. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.